ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 12th பாசுரம். கனைத்திலங்கற்றெருமை கன்று கிறங்கி நினைத்து முலை வழியே நின்று பால் சோர நனைத்தில்லம் சேராக்கும் நற்செல்வன் தங்காய் மணித்தலை வீழ நின் வாசற்கடை பற்றி சினத்தினால் தென்னிலங்கை கோமானை செற்ற மனத்து கிணியானை பாடவும் நீவாய் திறவாய் இனித்தான் எழுந்திராய் ஈதென்ன பேருறக்கம் அனைத்தில்லத்தாரும் அறிந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் இஸ் வேக்கிங் அப் ஹர் சீனியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் இன் த தேர்ட் சீன் ஆஃப் திருப்பாவை. ஷி டஸ் நாட் வாண்ட் டு லீவ் பிஹைண்ட் அ சிங்கிள் ஃப்ரெண்ட் இன் த டிவைன் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த பாவை நோம்பு. ஸோ ஷீ இஸ் என்ஷூரிங் தட் ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி கேர்ள் இஸ் கால்ட் ஃபார் அண்ட் டேக்கன் இன் டு ஹர் குரூப். ஸோ இந்த குரூப் ஆஃப் சீனியர் கேர்ள்ஸ், த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கேர்ள் வாஸ் ஓக்கன் அப் இன் த 11th பாசுரம் எஸ்டர்டே. ஷீ வாஸ் கால்ட் பொற்கொடி விசா. டுடே ஷீ இஸ் கோயிங் டு த ஹவுஸ் ஆஃப் த செகண்ட் சீனியர் கேர்ள் அண்ட் இட் சீம்ஸ் தட் திஸ் கேர்ள்ஸ் பிரதர் இஸ் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பெஸ்ட் ஃப்ரெண்ட் அண்ட் திஸ் பாய் இஸ் நோன் பை த நேம் நற்செல்வன். நற்செல்வன் மீன்ஸ் த ஒன் ஹூ ஹாஸ் குட் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் வெல்த். வாஸ் திஸ் பாய் ரியலி வெல்தி ஆஸ் ஹிஸ் நேம் இண்டிகேட்ஸ்? தி ஆன்சர் இஸ் வீல் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட். திஸ் பாய் வாஸ் சச் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட் அண்ட் டிவோட்டி ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா தட் ஹி வாஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் இன்வால்வ்ட் இன் டூயிங் சர்வீஸ் டு கிருஷ்ணா பை பீயிங் ஆன் ஹிஸ் சைட் ஆல்வேஸ். He was always seen with Krishna only. He was wherever Krishna was present. So he did not have time to actually take care of his house or his cattle. So the cattle in his house were not at all looked after. And his house was not kept clean, spick and span. So this house was a contrast to the house we saw yesterday. Yesterday we saw that the gopas in the house were very particular about doing their duty, and so they had well maintained cattle and a very neat and prosperous house. But this particular house is totally opposite. The cattle are not looked after, the house is not kept neat, and the cattle are so much not looked after that there is nobody to even take out milk from them. And so these cattle are shouting or mooing to their calves so that the calves can come and drink the milk and relieve them of the stress of having excess milk. So it seems even buffaloes are shouting in this house. Buffaloes are supposed to be a little lethargic. They don't proactively give milk like the cows. But even these buffaloes have overflowing milk, and the milk from these buffaloes is overflowing and flooding the house. So this is the scenario of the house that Andal describes in the start of the pasuram. kanaiththiLam kaTRerumai kanru kirangi, she says. These erumai, that is buffaloes, are all making all kinds of noises. kanaiththiLam kaTRerumai, young buffaloes, young mother buffaloes, are shouting out for their calves. kanru kirangi. And they are shouting out because excess of milk is getting produced in them and they want to give it out. And these calves are not coming because nobody is untying the calf and sending it to the buffalo. So automatically it seems milk is flowing out from these buffaloes. நினைத்து முலை வழியே நின்று பால் சோர. As the buffaloes are thinking of their calves and making this sound, lot of milk is overflowing out and there's a flood of milk present outside the house. இன்று பால் சோர நனைத்து இல்லம் சேராக்கும். And people who are in the house are really not bothered about it. They are walking over this milk flood, and because of that the entire place has become very messy and very damp. சேராக்கும், she is saying. It has become all wet, damp and clumsy. So that is the scenario present in the house. Now, if a house is kept like this, will there be prosperity in this house ever? We need to take care of the house, we need to take care of cattle, and we need to take good care of our belongings. The cattle is the house's responsibility, and the people in the house are totally not worried about their responsibility. So will this house be prosperous and be going in the good direction at all? The answer is, we would think that it would not. But Andal says that the person in the house, the person in charge of the house, the head of the house, that is the brother of her friend, is called as Narchelvan, the wealthy one, the prosperous one. He has prosperity, it seems. How is this prosperity coming? The answer is, this boy is not worried about material prosperity at all. The prosperity that he is looking at is the service of the Lord. The service of the Lord is called Kaikarya Shri, or the wealth of service. And that wealth of service this boy has in abundance, because he is always at the beck and call of Krishna to give him any kind of service at any point of time. That is why he is not having time to look at these material responsibilities, and he is not actually worried about that also. Apparently, this is also a way of devotion. There are many ways to be devoted to the Lord. Like how in the last house we saw that people were being very responsible, taking care of everything, and in the process of taking care of their material things, they were trying to build strength for doing divine service. They were trying to be fit to serve Krishna. So that is also a kind of devotion. And such devotional people are called karma yogis. Now, this boy is also extremely devoted. He is so devoted that he is not having any time for his material needs. So, this boy is following something like bhakti yoga. So, any kind of service or dedication to the Lord is acceptable, they say. That is why this boy is called as Narchelvan, the prosperous one. Because this boy was like Lakshmana, it seems. Lakshmano Lakshmi Sampannaha, they say. Lakshmana is called Lakshmana because he had Lakshmi, prosperity in abundance. And why did he have prosperity in abundance? Because he had the prosperity of serving Lord Rama by being with him all the time. Rama gave up his kingdom and went to the forest. So at that time, he lost the prosperity of his kingdom, people say. But at the same time, Lakshmana gained the prosperity of serving Lord Rama. So it is said that the prosperity of Lakshmana was eternal because he was always involved in serving Rama. And this kind of prosperity is the real prosperity, they say. So Krishna is very, very happy with this Narchelvan. And so Andal doesn't want to leave out his sister at all from her group. She wants to take this girl along very desperately. She's calling out to her, Narchelvan Tangai. Oh, my dear friend, the sister of Narchelvan, please come out. We are not even able to enter your house. You know how we are placed now? What is our state now? We are actually holding on to your gate and hanging from it literally. Panithalai veezhanin vasarkadai patri, meaning we are hanging on to your gate present outside your house. Then the girl inside is now surprised. She's like, why are these girls hanging on to my gate? Why can't they stand on the ground? So Andal answers, see, my dear friend, the state of your house. We are all entangled in a flood. There's a flood of dewdrops coming from up because this is the month of Margadi. And there's a flood of milk below our feet. So we can't stand down. And our hearts are also flooded with devotion to Lord Krishna. So we are all actually suffering from flood and have become flood hit. So you need to save us from this flood. The floods of dew, the flood of milk, and the flood of devotion that we have in the heart. So why don't you come out and save us from this flood? Please come, she's saying. This girl is not yet coming out. So one of the friends of Andal present outside say that, see, I know one secret about this girl, this Narchelvan Tangai. You know what is that? This girl is the sister of Narchelvan, who is like Lakshmana. So, she is very fond of Rama. So, I think if we sing of Lord Rama instead of Krishna, probably she will come out. So, let us tell her something about Rama. And so, Andal and her friends proceed to talk about Rama. They say, Sinathinal tennilangai komanai chetra manathu kiniyanai padavum. We are all singing the glory of Lord Rama, who is known as Manathu Kiniyan. Manathukiniyan means the one who is very sweet and pleasing to the heart. Rama can be understood as Ramate iti Ramaha. Rama is known as Rama because he is very sweet to our hearts. If we think of Rama, if we utter the name Rama, a special kind of sweetness comes up in our minds and hearts. That's why he is known as Rama, it seems. So, this Rama we shall sing about. Manathikkiniyanai paadavum. And she also describes Rama using a special adjective. She says, Sinathinal thennilangai komanai chetra manathikkiniyan. This Manathikkiniyan Rama is the one who one day went in anger, Sinathinal, to the southern Lanka, thennilangai, and defeated its king, Komanaichatra. He defeated the king of Lanka in a war due to anger, she's saying. Now, we all know Lord Rama. He's the most calm person known in the world. He's known for his calmness. Karuna Kakutstha, says Swami Deshikan. Karuna or mercy is his greatest guna or character. So, instead of highlighting that characteristic of Rama, Andal is saying the angry Rama. Why is she saying? Because the one who does not get easily angry is angered by somebody. And the anger of a calm person is much more serious and important than somebody who always gets angry. So, Rama's anger is something really special and important. Rama doesn't get angry so easily. But he was angered by the king of Lanka. Why? Not because he was fighting against Rama. Rama did not get angry on Ravana when Ravana shooted arrows at him. Instead, when he started shooting arrows at Hanuman, who was carrying Rama during the battle, Rama couldn't control his anger, it seems. And at that time, he discharged arrows which made Ravana totally weaponless, or Nirayudha Pani, as he said. And in this state of weaponlessness, Lord Rama told Ravana that I grant you one more day. You go and come. Go get yourself equipped and come back again for battle. Another single arrow could have slain Ravana at that time. But again, Rama is Karuna Kakutstha, so he decided to give Ravana another chance. But he couldn't tolerate any injustice or any wrong done to his devotee Hanuman. That is why he got so much anger into him that he could make Ravana Nirayudha Pani or weaponless. He did not get so angry. In fact, he did not get angry at all when Ravana was shooting arrows at him. So that is the anger of the Lord. Lord gets angered when his devotees are wronged. And this beautiful characteristic of the Lord, Andal wanted to highlight. So she has put the term, Sinathinal thennilangai komanai chetra manathikkiniyan. So we are singing about this Lord Rama who rushes down to save his devotees, getting angry very much against his normal characteristic only for our sake. So please come out. We are singing so much, but you're not even opening your mouth. Nee vai thiravai. You're not opening your mouth. You have to get up now. Inita nirindirai. Please get up now at least. We have sung the name of Rama. And Rama's name is one which is known to be Mrita Sanjeevana. Mrita Sanjeevana means the one which can even resurrect the dead ones. So, even if somebody was sleeping their last sleep, he would have got up and come now because we are uttering the name of Rama. And you are still sleeping. Inita nirindirai, she's saying. Idenna perurakkam. Is this that long sleep that you have gone into from which you don't want to get up? Even if it is so, even if you have gone into such a sleep, the last sleep, still you can get up and come because we have sung the name of Mrita Sanjeevana Rama. Get up and come. Anaithillattaru marindelorembavai. See, everybody around, anaithillattaru, are looking at us. The way we are holding on to the gate and calling out Rama, Rama for your sake, and you're not coming. You have made us a scene to the world. Please come out now, she requests. And this girl, this Narchelvan's sister, laughs and comes out saying that, "Wow, I just had to hear the name of Rama from you people, and now I'm happy that you have sung. Let us all proceed for the vratam."